Sometimes looking at older technology can be fascinating. In the 1980s and 1990s, this is how you'd watch movies and record shows off your television. In this video, we're going to take a look at the inside of a VCR and show how it works. This is the VCR. It stands for Video Cassette Recorder. It plays VHS cassette tapes. VHS stands for Video Home System. Take the tape, push it in, press play, and there's your movie. The VCR is becoming a thing of the past. If you were born after about the year 2000, you might not have even used one of these. Nowadays, there's DVDs and Blu-ray. Why use these when you can just stream everything off the internet? The VCR is probably not going to make a comeback, but to me, this is still a fascinating piece of technology. To really understand it, we need a little bit of background. In the early 1900s, if you wanted to watch anything on a screen, you had to leave your house and go to a movie theater. Black and white televisions made their way into homes by the 1950s. In the 1960s came the color TV. Then in the late 1970s came VHS. This was a huge game changer. Previously, you were limited to what was being broadcast at that time. So if a TV program was on at 7 p.m., then you had to be in front of your TV at 7 p.m. There was no way to record it. With VHS, you could now record TV programs and bring home your favorite movies to watch whenever you wanted. This was a big deal. Now, to be fair, there was another competitor called Betamax. It looked and worked very similar to VHS. Betamax was slightly higher quality, but VHS was slightly cheaper and could store a longer length of video. After a few years of battling it out, VHS won over, and that's why most people today are familiar with VHS. VCRs and VHS tapes were most popular during the 1980s and 1990s. Then we saw its decline in the early 2000s when DVDs began to rise in popularity. DVDs could produce better quality and you could fit a lot more of them on a shelf next to each other. However, even today, there are some enthusiasts that still use VHS. And lucky for me, you can still pick up a VCR player at a thrift store for only 10 or 20 US dollars. When I was younger, I remember looking inside and seeing all of the parts. I remember thinking, how does it work? So this video is an attempt to satisfy the curiosity that I had when I was younger. First, let's take a look at the VHS cassette tape. You can see two reels inside. From the bottom, you can see how the VCR will spin these. In the front is the spring-loaded door. This is normally locked into place. The VCR will press right here to move back a small plate, which then unlocks the door. When the door is open, you can see the magnetic tape where the movie is stored. I would highly recommend not touching this with your fingers. You could ruin the tape and make it unwatchable. On the bottom of the VHS is 5 screws. Take these out, and then the top half of the plastic outer shell comes off. As the movie plays, the magnetic tape will slowly move from the supply reel all the way over to the take-up reel. Part of the tape will actually be pulled out so the VCR can read it. But I'll show you how that works later in the video. Most VHS tapes hold about 248 meters of tape. If you were to unravel all of this, it would be enough tape to extend most of the way up the Eiffel Tower. That's a lot of tape. This is the reel lock mechanism. It prevents the reels from rotating, which keeps the magnetic tape from coming out. When the VHS tape is inside of the machine, a piece of metal will poke up through this hole. This will push the lever, which will unlock both reels. If the video was rewound all the way, then the magnetic tape should be completely on the left side. I can still remember the old stickers on VHS rentals that would say, "Be kind, rewind." Sometimes you would get charged a small fee if you didn't rewind it. Now let's look at the actual VCR player. After undoing a few screws, part of the case usually comes right off. There were a handful of companies that made these machines, and quite a few different models. But overall, they will be very similar because they all need to be able to read the same VHS tapes. Here's a few of the main parts. The circuit board, which controls most of the electronics, the power cord, which comes to the back of the machine and connects to the circuit board, the motor, which runs most of the mechanical operations, the RF tuner, which reads channels being broadcast over the air, and the actual VCR mechanism is right here in the center of the machine. There is a complex system of gears to move the mechanical parts of the machine. Let's start here with the carriage loading assembly. This is where you insert the VHS tape. The mechanism takes over and lowers it down. Did you catch all that? There were many things that just happened at once. Let's see it again. Notice the spring-loaded door at the front of the VHS. When the tape comes down, this door opens up, which exposes the magnetic tape. On the base plate of the machine, you'll see two guide rollers. The VCR motor can move these along curved tracks. When the tape is inserted, the guide rollers will fit right into these holes on the bottom of the VHS. When the guide rollers move, it pulls the tape along with it. This happens every time you put in a VHS tape. This is how the VCR gets ready to play the movie. Sometimes they call this the M-loading system, because the shape of the magnetic tape kind of looks like the letter M. The tape is wrapped around the drum. This is the part that reads information on the magnetic tape. You might be thinking, the drum is crooked, isn't it? Did somebody put it in wrong? Maybe it's broken? Nope, this is intentional. It's supposed to be tilted by just a few degrees. Later in the video, I'll show you why. But first, let me show you a few more of the parts. This is the capstan, and this is the pinch roller. When the machine is in play mode, the roller spins, which will slowly pull the tape. It's important to keep the magnetic tape pulled tight against the drum. That's the job of the two tension arms right here and here. This is the erase head. When the VCR is in record mode, the picture and audio will be erased before new information is written by the drum. This is the audio and control track head. This writes and reads the sound and extra information to the magnetic tape. When we want to rewind or fast forward the VHS, the tension arms and pinch roller will disengage. Then the spools beneath the VHS will take over. If it's in fast forward, then they'll spin clockwise. But if it's in rewind, then they'll spin counterclockwise. These can move very quickly so that you don't have to wait as long. The VCR has to stop before the end, or it could snap the magnetic tape, which would make it unwatchable. But how does it know how to do this? How does it know when to stop? Well, there's a tiny LED light right in the middle here. And then end of tape sensors on each side. When the VHS tape is inside the machine, the LED light will be blocked by the magnetic tape. But once it gets to the very end, the tape is clear. Now the light can shine all the way to the sensors. This is how the VCR knows that it's reached the beginning or end of the tape. There's one more sensor I'd like to point out. This is the record sensor. There's a little square tab on the front of the VHS tape. This is what tells the VCR sensor whether it's okay to record or not. If there's a tab there, then the VCR will let you record on the tape. But if it's been broken off, then the VCR will prevent you from recording. This is why store-bought VHS movies wouldn't have the tab. It would be a shame to record over a priceless movie. Let's talk more specifically about the drum and how you read and write information to the magnetic tape. On the side, you'll see several small holes. These are the heads that can read or write the information. Some machines only have two of these, but higher quality machines will have up to six heads. Sometimes the front of your VCR will actually tell you how many heads are in the drum. The top half of the drum will be spinning at up to 1800 RPMs, or rotations per minute. The magnetic tape will be moving at only a few centimeters per second. Remember that the drum is not actually pulling the magnetic tape. That's the job of the pinch roller that we saw earlier in the video. This pulls the tape so it now slides along the surface of the drum. Here is the reason that the drum is tilted. On the magnetic tape, the video information will be written in diagonal lines. This is to optimize the best use of the entire width of the magnetic tape. The writing and reading of these lines will be done by the heads inside of the drum. You can see how the heads stick out just barely so that they touch the surface of the magnetic tape. So the heads are spinning around, and then the tape is slowly being pulled. If you follow the magnetic patterns, the heads will be tracing along these diagonal lines. This is referred to as helical scan. It's the method for how they read and write information to the magnetic tape. These heads are sensitive to the magnetic patterns on the tape. This makes a signal which moves through the electronics and up to your TV, where it is then converted into the picture that you see. If your VCR is in record mode, the video signal from your TV will be converted into magnetic patterns that will then be stored onto the magnetic tape. Once the magnetic tape gets past the drum, it then comes past the audio and control trackhead. This will read and write sound information to the very top of the magnetic tape. Remember, the green diagonal lines, that's the video information, what you see on the TV screen. And the blue at the top, that's the sound information, or what you hear from your TV. Then the bottom of the tape is used for extra information that tells the VCR how fast to move the magnetic tape. For those who remember, this was the result of the tape speed setting. You could fit more video onto your tape in exchange for lower quality playback. Some VCRs had a feature called hi-fi audio, which is basically higher quality sound. It had two specific audio heads inside of the drum. The sound information could be written in the same space as the video. The audio would be written deeper inside so that it wouldn't be confused with the video signal. When you're all done, it's time to eject the tape. We basically just do everything in reverse. The tension arms go back in, then the pinch roller comes out, the magnetic tape goes back in, the VHS door closes, and the tape comes out of the machine. Notice this lever on the right side. When it gets bumped, it will then pull open the outer door so the VHS tape can come through. There are a handful of controls on the front of the VCR. Each one of these controls has a corresponding button on the circuit board. Press the control, and inside this moves a small lever, which then presses the button. This is how you control the VCR player. Knowing how complex a VCR is, it's amazing that they hold up for so long. Even if you take good care of it, avoid getting dust or moisture inside, and avoid putting any objects inside the front. This is a very bad idea, by the way. These sensitive components will eventually wear out. And in fact, VHS tapes won't last forever either. So if you have any precious home movies stored on here, it's a good idea to not wait too long before transferring them to digital storage, which will last a lot longer. My name's Jared. I create 3D animations to show and explain how things work. Watch another animation by clicking one of these cards, or click here to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.